Thank you for watching, and in this video I am going to explain how we can link our display items back to custom property. So if for that purpose, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna right click anywhere in this gray area, and then I'm gonna go into edit sheet format. So as you can see, into the sheet format, if I'm gonna bring my cursor anywhere on these information, so you can see there is a code which is stated PRP sheet description or PRP software file name or PRP revision. So it means like these are data is belongs to custom properties. So what I'm gonna do is if I'm gonna go into the annotations, and then I'm gonna go into the notes, and then wherever I want to add my notes. So what I can do is I can just insert my note box somewhere wherever I want to add, and then I can add my text here, or there are other options like if I want to go into the feature manager. So you can see there is an option for link to properties, or there is another option if you want to insert hyperlink. So I'm gonna go in that, and then I can insert my hyperlink or my URL, and then if I'm gonna insert that here, so whenever someone is gonna click on that, so it is gonna move to that hyperlink or that URL. Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, I'm gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video, where you can find my course link, in which I have over 10 hours of videos in which I explain each and every command in a detailed way. Thank you. Okay, so I'm gonna go back into the link to properties, and then into the link to properties, you can see there are two options. The first one is if I want to current document, or if I want model found here. So I'm gonna go into the model found here, and then I can go into the properties, and let's say if I want to go for the material, and then you can see this box is gonna fill with the material, because the material which is belong to the custom properties, and that custom properties belongs to the part. So that's why it's gonna come here. Or you can see we already have a material here, so I want to change it to something else. Let's go and let's say like drawn by. As you can see, there is no name like who draw this part, so I'm gonna go into the drawn by. So you can see like the evaluation is uname, so uname is the one who drawn this part, so that's why we can find this name here. And then if I'm gonna click OK, so the name is here, and then after that I can reduce the size, or if you want to change the color, or if you want to change the font, or whatever you want to do, so still you can do that. So what you can do is you can just update according to your requirement, and then you can click the green check mark, and after that you can just move it anywhere wherever you want. Suppose I want to move it here, and then I'm gonna click the green check mark. Okay, so if I'm gonna go back into the part, so I'm gonna go back into the part, and then I can go into the custom properties, and then I can see like if there is a drawn by, so that you can see there is a uname here, and even about the material, so this is here and this is the material. So in this way, what we can do is we can link back to custom properties all the display items what are into the SolidWorks drawing. And that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. And if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, then don't forget to check the course link in the description. Thank you. Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, I'm gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video, where you can find my course link, in which I have over 10 hours of videos in which I explain each and every command in a detailed way. Thank you.